me help you.
What do you even want?
Well, I'm motivated by self-interest. I just want to mess with you. I mean, mess with the timeline. It's long and boring, and my friends all think it's set in stone. They're probably right, but what do you say we take a chance and taste what happens? I'm sure you are wise to the laws of this game, but in looking at the letter, there is no shame. The spirit of the rules says to play along, but with a little legal prowess, you never can go wrong. Sure, you could build up to reach that gate, but why not accelerate to claim your fate? Here's a pretty little boon I'll grant to you. A dainty pair of wings if you just
chew.
Chew? Typhius, your denizen, sleeps in his lair. A canny restless brat like you, it's just not fair. Hit him fast and hit him hard, you're sure to win. And you'll get your just reward before you even begin.
I guess I'm gonna go try out this code and see if it does the trick.
Okay, John. I'm sure once you're done, even you and your underdeveloped bone neck will be able to figure out what to do. Talk to you on the other side!
Hey, I'm in.
In where?
The medium.
Oh, how'd it go?
Imagine the worst day of my life. Just stood up as you clinked a glass. I was about to give toast and then passed out and passed out for dinner.
No. Well, I just got this cool rocket pack and I'm gonna blast off into space.
Okay. Look, I need some advice. My Colonel Sprite turned into this, like, bigger feathery asshole with a sword in it. I think it wants me to prototype it again. I'm not sure what to do.
Well, it's supposed to be like your ghostly spirit guide or something. Unless you have the ashes of a wise old dead grandparent lying around, I'm not sure what to tell you.
Okay, but it seems to be suggesting something here, and I guess I'm a little weirded out.
Well, it's supposed to know stuff about the game, so it probably knows better than I do. Look, I gotta go. I'm gonna blast off to the seventh gate and win the game, I guess.
Okay, well, it definitely sounds like you're fucking something up over there. Do you trust this troll girl?
Come on, what's the worst that could happen?
Jade, are you there? I haven't talked to you in a while. Are you all right?
Hey, man, are you okay?
Jade? Whatever you're doing in this game must be keeping you busy, huh? You'll tell me if you're all right, right?
I warned you about the troll girl. I told you, dog.
Jade, I guess there's only a slim chance that these messages will be reaching you, but I thought I had to try. Wherever you are, and whatever you're doing, I hope you're safe.
John?
Please be safe.
Above are empty and there's nothing left to find. In this game without its players, there's no use in keeping score as we circle around the finish with no winning anymore.
There is nothing left here for-
the cold inside my soul.
I can turn back time again and buy another chance to win. Sacrifice another life to hang on to the hope that in another turn our fortune may reverse to set things right. Time left to pile up, I'm standing on a swelling grave. In the thick of all these failures, what's another dying day? But every time I have to watch the ones around me fade away. The ones I wish I could protect, drowning in the fray. You deserve a better hero, someone I could never be. And maybe when we go back, I'll have been a better me. And maybe one more turn is all it takes till we survive. And maybe I won't fail, and I will keep us all alive. In this game, the night is backwards, should be taken like a pawn. So the heroes can move forward after I am dead and gone. So my Colonel Sprite just turned into this like bigger feathery asshole with a sword through it, and I think he wants me to prototype it again. I'm not sure what to do.
Well, it's supposed to be like your ghostly spirit guide or something. Unless you have the ashes of a wise old dead grandparent lying around, I'm not sure what to tell you.
Okay, but it seems to be suggesting something here, and I'm kind of weirded out.
Well, it's supposed to know stuff about the game, so it probably knows better than I do. Look, I gotta go. I'm gonna blast off to the seventh gate and win the game, I guess.
Wait, hang on.
Huh?
It's me from the future. I just appeared and I'm a bird. He says, don't go or you're gonna die.
This is some terrible April Fool's Day prank 12 days late.
John, stop being a tool. If our friendship needs anything, you'll listen to me. Just stay on the goddamn ground, okay? I'm turning this timeline over to past Dave and helping you all do this right this time.
There's no way I'm missing out on this sweet ride.
What do I have to do to make you believe us?
You're my bestest bro. I guess if you say not to do it, I'll listen. Hang on, I'm getting trolled.
Right, because talking to those D-bags is a great idea.
Just try not to die this time? Like, is this John business? Is he gonna be okay?
If he decides to listen to us.
And if he doesn't?
We'll just bail him out again.
So, do you know everything about the game now?
Yeah, most stuff. But in these, like, riddles. I don't know, I'm supposed to be all arcane, but I don't really give a shit, so go ahead and ask.
Alright, why are we so goddamn awesome?
That is the best fucking question anybody ever asked.
Dave? Are you there?
Yeah.
Well, I've been thinking about something. Do you remember how I used to tease Jade about her crystal ball? Well, last year for my birthday, she had gifted me with one. More of a cue ball, really. She said that she had no use for it anymore, but that I would, soon. Ever since I entered the game, I've been able to see strange things. Not the future as she had suggested, but I think I'm starting to realize my abilities as the Seer of Light. I can see our game's final bosses, the Black Kings and Queens. You know how our imps and minor enemies all bear traits of our pre-entry prototypings?
Flying seppuku basilisks are kind of hard to forget.
Well, the process works in much of the same way for the Black and White Kings and Queens. They wear a band that enables them to draw power from our initial prototypings. Or at least I think it's the bands, for these traits do not transfer onto their agents, the Jacks. for example. Though this did have a comedic consequence of an altered dress code in order to match the traits of the monarchs. For us, that would mean your skewered bird. And my dear dead cat. As well as John's harlequin doll. And whatever else Jane decides to prototype. Though, I don't think this will have much of an effect on my gameplay at all. This game is turning out to be much easier than expected.